Well, that's a very good question. That he said, I said in my speech, and according to the verse of the Quran of Surah Maida, chapter 5, verse 32, which says that strongest in enmity to the Muslims would be the Jews and the pagans, and the closest in love would be the Christians. So he's saying, won't it create enmity when they say that the Jews and the Muslims should fight? The Quran doesn't say Jews and the Muslims should fight. The Quran says strongest in enmity to the Muslims, to the believers, will be Jews. It does not say that Muslims should fight with the Jews. It doesn't say that. But it says that the Jews, by nature as a whole, they'll be against Muslims. And I told in my lecture, there are many Jews who accepted Islam. There are many Jews who are good to Muslims. But as a whole, if you take Jews as a whole and the Christians as a whole, the Christians are closer than the Jews as a whole. This is a fact. For example, the Quran says that the Jews are intelligent also. So that's a fact. If they're intelligent, they're intelligent. That doesn't mean that it hides the fact. And the Quran also says that they will be as a whole a staunchest enemy. So this is one of the falsification tests. That today, if you want to prove the Quran wrong, if the Jews get together, all of them, and they decide, let's prove the Quran wrong. At least for 3-4 years, we will be better than the Christians. Let's stop the war of Palestine. You know the Palestinians? The Jews were kicked out by Hitler. Hitler insinuated 6 million Jews. He kicked them out of Germany. The Arabs, the Palestinians, they do Alan Vasalan. Come with open arms. After a few years, they're kicked out of the home. Imagine someone gives the traveler his home to live, and the traveler kicks him out of his home, and he's shouting that he has taken my house, and you're calling them terrorists. So what they have to do is, let's get together and solve this problem. Whatever the problem is, today, America is controlled by the Jews. Whether it be the banks, whether it be the money, whether it be the power. According to the American survey, no one can become a president of USA without walking the Star of David. So the Jews are a minority, less than 5% in America. But they're controlling the economy, they're controlling America. Fine? So if they're controlling America, let's solve the problem of Palestine, let's solve the American problem. Not forever, few years. 4-5 years only, and the problem is solved. So we aren't telling that the Muslims should fight with the Jews. In fact, the Quran says, even if your enemy wants peace, several places, even if they come to fight you, it's mentioned in Surah Anfal, in the battle, if they want peace, give it to them. So Quran is always for peace. Quran is always encouraging them. But if a person does not want peace to prevail, what can we do? Islam is a religion of peace. It wants peace, but it even mentions facts. That means we have to be careful of the Jews. Not that we have to fight them, unless they come and fight with you. That's a different thing. Imagine what's happening in Palestine, what's happening in other parts of the world. So brother, for peace to prevail, you have to follow the guidance of the Quran and live harmoniously rather than be enemies.
Can we have the next question from the brother's side?
Good night. My name is Lim Kim Piu. So I think it is good for the Muslim extremists. Muslim against extremists against the Western Christian who are ego and proud. Because the Western Christian are rich, developed and progressed. And they look down on the Hindu, Muslim and Buddhist. And the Muslim consists of over 40 countries. And the Buddhist over 10 countries. And the Hindu just a few. Nobody there to challenge against the Christian. Only the Muslim dare to challenge against the Christian.
The brother has said emotionally that the Christian of the Western country, they look down upon the Buddhists, the Muslims, the Hindus, and no one dares to challenge the Western Christians except the Muslims. Brother, I slightly differ. What you're saying is right. All Muslims don't have the guts to challenge the Western world. There are some Muslims like Tun Dr. Mahathir Muhammad. All the Muslims don't have the guts. And I am a person who is not very much in favor of politicians. There are very few politicians who I respect. And one of them is Tun Dr. Mahathir Muhammad. And I remember when I met him the first time several years back in Abu Dhabi, we were discussing, and he said that if the Muslims, if the Arabs stop dealing in dollars, America will come on its knees immediately. There are few politicians who I really care. One was King Faisal of Saudi Arabia. He had the guts. I remember when you read his biography that when oil was discovered, he said, let's have the meeting in the desert. And that time when they pressurized the Muslims, King Faisal said that we are Badus, we are Bedouin, we are Arabs, we can go back to the desert. What will happen to you when we stop giving you oil? And I believe one of the things of Dr. Tun Mahathir Mohamad was that if he had the control of the oil, what the Arabs had, he would have ruled the world. That's why I said in my lecture of terrorism, Muslim monopoly, that most of the terrorist acts, directly or indirectly, are related to politicians. They try and create the vote bank. They create all this problem. I agree with you totally that the Western world, they think that they are superior. They think they're superior. The only way you can be superior is by being extra God conscious, by being righteous, by being pious, not by setting rules. And when the Western world talks about justice, when they talk about freedom of expression, if it does not hurt them, you have freedom of expression. If it hurts them, no freedom of expression. And the Western world talking about justice, I feel that one of the most unjust countries in the world are the Western countries. They talk about justice, but they are far away from justice. However much they are trying to attack Islam, Islam is growing. Islam is growing. There are, mashallah, few Muslims who speak against the Western world, and the Western world tries and shut their voice. That's what they tried to do to your ex-prime minister, but mashallah, Allah helped him and he came up again. We know the history. And that's what they do, that those Muslims who speak the truth, because of my being very vocal and speaking the truth, the Western world doesn't like me speaking the truth. I'd like to give an example. I have been to UK several times. In 2010, when we had the Wembley Arena, we had the NEC Arena in Birmingham. There, the Home Secretary took objection to one of my statements. I said that killing innocent people is prohibited in Islam. And I said that thousands of people killed in the Twin Tower is to be condemned. The thousands of human beings killed in Twin Tower blast in 9/11 is to be condemned. More than 50 people killed in the London Tube blast is to be condemned. More than 180 people killed in Bombay in the train blast has to be condemned. But I told the Muslim, don't put a full stop. Besides condemning all this, I also condemn the thousands of innocent people killed in Afghanistan, in Iraq and Palestine. So the Home Secretary of UK put a ban. Zakir cannot enter UK. I told that the thousands of Americans killed in the Twin Tower, I condemn. More than 50 Britishers killed in London, condemn. More than 180 Indians killed, condemn. But I was careful, the thousands of innocent people killed in Afghanistan. I didn't say thousands of Afghanistanis. Because, you know, the Western world considers some are terrorists. So I was careful in using my statement. Thousands of innocent people killed in Afghanistan, in Iraq, in Palestine. So they want to ban me. They talk about freedom of expression. As long as you don't expose them, they don't mind. Once you expose them, they don't like freedom of expression. So I do agree with you. But alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah. However much they try and suppress Islam, Islam is spreading. The more they try and suppress Islam, the more Islam is spreading. Whatever they do, because Allah has given a promise that this deen will prevail over all the deens. And today, what the Western world is fearing maximum, they fear Islam. That's the reason they're bringing all these restrictions, etc. But what they do, inshallah, we believe in the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Islam will spread and is bound to spread. Allah doesn't require me or other people to make Islam spread. Allah has given a promise in the Quran, and inshallah, very shortly, you will see this coming true, that the power from the Western world will be taken away. Hope that answers the question.